A group of 11 Republican fake Trump donors in the state of Georgia have petitioned the judge that is working, of course, to oversee the Fulton County Fannie Willis special grand jury investigation into possible election interference by Trump and his cronies in Georgia. So a group of 11 of the fake Trump electors have now petitioned the judge for a second time, trying to get Fannie Willis removed from the case. But the interesting part is they don't want her removed entirely from the investigation. Just, of course, the investigation into them. Because here's what happened, and I talked about this recently. It was a stupid, stupid mistake by Fannie Willis. The only mistake she has made so far. She went out there and was the headliner at a campaign event for the Democratic candidate for lieutenant governor in the state of Georgia. Well, the man that candidate is running against happens to be Republican State Senator Burt Jones. And Burt Jones is also a subject of Fannie Willis's investigation. So she was out there campaigning and raising money for Jones's opponent while investigating Jones. Big error, huge error, an error that made the judge say, Fannie Willis, you can no longer investigate Burt Jones. We will assemble a separate prosecutorial team that's going to look into what Burt Jones did, but because you're clearly not impartial, you can't investigate him. So now these 11 fake electors who are clearly, you know, targets in this investigation have petitioned the judge. Hey, judge, what about us, right? Oh, we worked on the campaign. We were with this guy. We're, you know, tied at the hip with Jones. So if she can't be impartial to Jones, she can't be impartial to us. So you got to get her off our backs too. Now, they had already made that argument when the judge decided on the Jones situation. And the judge said, no, y'all aren't excused from this. She can still go after you. So now they've regrouped, retooled their message, and said basically... Indeed, because Senator Jones has been removed from this investigation, there's arguably an even greater likelihood that the officers of his campaign partners, his running mates, his financial supporters, and his key political allies could be treated even more harshly. So these idiots are going to the judge and say, listen, everybody who's ever seen Burt Jones in their lives, she can't investigate them. Like the mailman that goes to his house every day. That's too connected to Jones. You got to cut it out. The Amazon delivery guy. You can't investigate him. I gave $5 to his campaign, so clearly she hates me and can't be impartial while investigating me. Those are the idiotic arguments that they're making. And again, they've attempted this with the judge before, so I don't know that they're going to see any success. But I'm still bothered by the fact that Fannie Willis made such a ridiculous error. It was totally not necessary. She has done a brilliantly beautiful job in this investigation and had to go be the headliner at that event. Had she not done that, man, this would have been a flawless investigation to date. But I do think she's clearly learned her lesson. Listen, I'm not going to mix into politics right now. I got a big job to do. And if she does this job correctly, hopefully she moves up that ladder. I could see an attorney general spot for her up there in the future. And I'd love to see that. She's got the one blemish. It kind of hurt the investigation, but it's not the end of the world. She has regrouped. She's coming back. Everything is moving forward. She's getting Lindsey Graham. She's getting Rudy Giuliani, right? She knows what she's doing. She knows the mistake she made. And I trust her to carry out this investigation impartially, something those fake Trump electors are clearly very worried about. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.